Welcome back, friends. Another expeditions episode from the Hidden Flag Brothers. Around the end of the winter, the hills of Karbianglong prepare for the district's annual flaps tax, like the neighboring state, Meghalaya. It's a harvest of brooms that goes all over the country. It's the time the local vendors around that reaches the farmers to collect the broom grass. They ask the farmer to bring their brooms at a place where from transportation is possible. They buy from them at a reasonable price, and the vendor sell that collected grasses to the upper section of the traders. There is an old Indian proverb: by sweeping your home in the morning with broom grass, you also wipe out negative thoughts and energies. Broom grass, or tiger grass, is a tall perennial grass of Bulsi family. Scientific name is Thysanolena maxima. In Assamese, it is called as Phuljharu. Inflorescences of these plants are used for making brooms, which is called grass brooms. These brooms made of plastics also available nowadays. The grass brooms are eco-friendly and biodegradable. The grass broom is an important part in every Indian household. Apart from broom making, the plant also plays an important role in other aspects also. Its fibrous root systems bind the soil and help to reduce the soil erosion in the hilly slopes. Areas of Karbianglong, not only the men, the women are also empowered to these types of cultivations. They help their men in every aspect to get the best benefits of their cultivated products. During the month of February and March, from their cultivated field, they bring their collected broomsticks to their homes. Let them dry for some time until the sticks get dried at their lower part. They just don't need to go to the local market to sell their products. The local vendor come directly to their house, negotiate the price. Shifting cultivation, slash and burn agriculture, that's called shroom. It encourages shifting cultivation, slash burn agriculture, that's shroom. It encourages degradation of forest over our hilly slopes, which tends to soil erosion and landslide. Broom grass can transform degraded land in a patch of greenery within 1 year of time. The green leaves of the plant supplies fodder for the cattle during lean period. Local tribes use broom sticks or its stem as wall building materials. Broom sticks are also tried as raw material in paper industry. In a northeast India, broom grass grows wild in hilly area. Karbi Anglong district is the highest producer of broom grass in India. Broom grass can be cultivated in a wide range of agroclimatic conditions, steep rocky mountain slopes to plain areas, sandy loam to clay loam soils. The crop is tolerated the drought situation while it's performed well in high rainfall conditions also, where there is no water logging in the hilly areas. The fruits of the whole year work had become sweets by the end of the March. On the recent studies, it has been found that broom grass of Karbi Anglong district is the best grooms all over India. The grooms of Karbi Anglong goes worldwide, which is supplied by the vendor of upper class sections to international market. Natural expansions of new areas take place by dissemination of seeds of the broom grass. Seeds are very light in weight, which mature in broom grass plants during the February and March, carried out by the wind. Its method of propagation can be artificially through seeds and rhizomes. The seeds can be collected from the mature inflorescence during February and March. Seeds cannot be sown directly in the main field. Seedlings are to produce from the seeds in nursery beds. Generally, nursery beds of 1 into 2 meter size are made, where 10 gram seeds per casted. Seeds are covered with thin layer of sand and watering is done to keep the seed bed moist. After 6 weeks, the seedlings are either transplanted into a second seed bed or raised in polythene bags, which we are filled with a mixture of soil. sand and farmyard manure. The rest seedlings are to be planted in a main field with the onset of rainy season. The broom grass can be planted to seeds and rhizomes. Till deep planting to rhizomes is easily and more successful method. My rhizomes are easy to transport to long distance for propagation. The rhizomes are collected by digging of roots from the wild or cultivated broom grass plants after harvesting of the brooms. The rhizomes cuts contain 2 to 3 cones with roots and buds. For more information about the plantations of the broom grass, please contact our channel, that is His Life Production. Thanking you all. Marketing of broom grass. There is a heavy demand of grass brooms in the local, national, and international market. In Assam, there are several buyers of grass brooms. That is Oink Agro and Livestock Production Limited, Ifu Karbi Anglong, Hindu Traders, Silchar. In Guwahati, there are various wholesaler dealers of grass brooms where farmers can contact for selling their products. In India, almost in every state, buyers and exporters of grass brooms are available. Farmers can search for better price and buyers in a website. That is www.exportersindia.com. Grass brooms from India are exported to Nepal, Yemen, Kuwait, Bangladesh, and USA. In USA, there is a demand for Indian grass brooms, which people purchase from the Indian markets available in USA. Therefore, marketing of grass brooms is not a problem, and farmer can go for increasing their production. Thank you all.